Good evening, students. In today's class, we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 11, mensuration. Mensuration means, in earlier classes, we could have learned like square shapes, square, rectangle, triangle. In mensuration, we are going to learn about the measures of those figures. That is why we call it as mensuration. So first, we have a quick recap of what we learned in our previous classes. That is, in our 6th, 7th and all, we would have learned area of a square, perimeter of square, area of rectangle, perimeter of rectangle. That is, the area and perimeters of the different shapes. First, let us have a quick recap of all those formulas and then we get into the 8th standard portion. So what we learned? We learnt about the shape of square. What do you mean by square? All four sides are equal. When you have a square, A, B, C, D, all the four sides are equal. A, B equal to B, C is equal to C, D is equal to A, D. And all four angles are equal. Angle A equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D, 90 degrees. But in mensuration, we are going to talk about only the sides. We are not going to talk about the angles much. We are going to talk about only the area, perimeter, and about volume. So, we are going to learn area, perimeter, and volume of the different shapes. So, we start with square. So, what we learn in square? Area of square is side into side. Then we learnt area of rectangle. Rectangle is what? Length into breadth. Then we learnt area of circle, which is pi r squared. Then we learnt area of triangle, half into base into height. This height, even we can say it as altitude. And also we learnt area of parallelogram. What we mean by parallelogram in that? Base into height. Then we learnt trapezium. Area of trapezium is half into sum of parallel sides into height. That is trapezium. Half into sum of parallel sides into trapezium. And also we learned about the surface area. Surface area of cuboid. Cuboid is what? It's a three-dimensional figure with a two rectangle. So when we talk about single dimension is square, rectangle, circle, triangle, parallelogram, trapezium. Then when you talk about the 3D figures, we call it as cuboid and cubes and cylinder. So we have this one as cuboid. Cuboid is made of rectangle. Then you will be having cubes. Cubes is made of square, where length, breadth, height you will have. Length, breadth, height. So in cube, it is made of cube means what? Cube is made of square. So length, breadth, height, everything will be equal. In cuboid, cuboid is made of rectangle. So we have different length, breadth, height. Okay, cube is made of square. So you will be having length, breadth, height are to be same. But cuboid is made of rectangle. So it is different. So now, surface area of cuboid, when we saw about the formula, 2 into LB plus BH plus HL, length into breadth, it's all in the shape of areas we will take. Then we call, put together, we call it as surface area. 2 into LB, length into breadth, breadth into height, height into length. Then cube, no, the same way, we substitute 2 into, here everything is same, no? Breadth also will become length. So, everything is same. So, we get here 2 into L squared plus L squared plus L square. L into L, L squared, L into L, L squared, L into L, L squared. So it will become how many times? 2 into 2, 1, 2, 3, 3 L squared. So this will become 6 L squared, where L is side, where L is equal to side of cube. So surface area of cube is 6 L squared, whereas surface area of cuboid is 2 into LB plus BH plus HL. Next we have cylinder. Cylinder is what shape for us? You know, cylinder is with the two circles at the top and bottom. We have this as 2 pi R into R plus H, surface area of cylinder. Now just we learn this class only about the formula. This surface area of cylinder, how to derive, we will do it in our 9th standard. Okay, so let us learn the formula as 2 pi r into r plus h. But for your basic information, because our LDTC students should not lag anywhere in the knowledge. So I'll tell you, this cylinder is made up of two area of a circle, is it not? So I'll draw a diagram here for you. A cylinder is made of two circles at the top and bottom. This is pi r squared and this is pi r square, area of a circle. Then when you think about the height, the cylinder here also it is in the shape of circle, right? Here also we have, what we will have? This is circumference of the circle. What is circumference of the circle? 2 pi r. And with the length into h. All this put together, we have surface area. This all this put together, pi r squared plus pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. This gives you pi r squared plus pi r squared is 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. So here we can see 2 pi r is common. We will take it out. Here r is left and that here h is left. That is why we say 2 pi r into r plus h. So surface area of cylinder is 2 pi r into r plus h. Now, next we learn about volume. Now, volume when you speak, it's for the which occupies the space. So first, you know, we should know about the difference between, now when we talk about area and perimeter, you just remember, you know what it is. But what we mean by area actually, area means surface enclosed, surface enclosed by their boundaries. Okay. Suppose when you have a rectangle, this ABCD is a boundary. So what is this one? This we call it as area. So when we have a square, what is the area of a square? The surface enclosed by the boundary. We call it as area. Then, you know, perimeter. What we mean by perimeter? Perimeter is distance around the figure. Distance around the figure. So what is this distance? AB, BC, CD plus AD. We add up. This distance, compound wall type, what you have? We call it as perimeter. Distance around the figure. But the area enclosed by the boundary, we call it as area. So, understood the difference between the area and perimeter? Perimeter means it's like a compound wall. The distance around the figure. Area is the space which is enclosed by the boundary of the figure. That is the difference between area and perimeter. So, when we talk about perimeter, we have the shapes of perimeter. In rectangle, the formula is 2 into length plus breadth. Then in the square, 4 into side. when you take up in the triangle, sum of all the three sides, AB plus BC plus CA. So, in general, if you are not able to find the perimeter, we just add up all the length of the boundaries, we get perimeter. So, we say perimeter is sum of all the sides given in the figure. That is called perimeter. Now let us do few problems based on this area and perimeter from our textbook. So in our textbook in page 170, we have a try this question. In this try this question, there are two questions A and B. In the question A, you have match the following figures with the respective areas in the box. You can see here there is a box. They have given some numbers 49, 77, 98 and they have given us 5 diagrams. So we have to find area of these 5 diagrams and we have to match it with 49 or 77 or 98. So first we understand the shapes. This is in the shape of parallelogram. So we find area of a parallelogram. Then here area of semicircle with the radius 7 cm. Then you have triangle. Then we have rectangle and then square. So we know all this area formula. We substitute and get the answer and we match it with 49 or 77 or 98. We match it with 49, 77 or 98. And also the question is given for us. Write the perimeter of each shape. After matching it, for these figures, 5 figures given, we have to write the perimeter. So use the perimeter formula, substitute the measurement of the side and we write what is the perimeter. So now let us move on to the sums for this to verify from this try this. So now take your textbook in that page 170. In the try this, there are 5 sums, 5 diagrams are given. The first one is, you have a parallelogram with one side 7 cm, another one 14 cm. So now what are the perimeters? First we have to find the area. Area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram is what? Base into height. So first we write area of, first we understand what is this diagram, parallelogram. So area of parallelogram is base into height. Here base is 14, height is 7, 14 sevens are, 7 fours are 28, 8 carry 2, 7 ones are 7, plus 2, 98 centimeter squared. So the first area of sum given, area of parallelogram is 98 centimeter squared. Next, B subdivision. B subdivision, it's a semicircle given. The semicircle, the full base is 14 centimeter. So what is this radius? Half of it, which is 7 centimeter. So this we say it as area of semicircle. What is area of semicircle? Half of area of circle. So what is area of circle? Half into pi r squared. So we write half into 22 by 7. Here radius is 7. Radius is 7 here, the diagram. So r is 7. R squared is 7 into 7. 17, 17 get cancelled. 2 will go in 22 11 times. 11 sevens are 77 centimeter squared. Always the area we measure it by unit square units. Now let us move on to C sum. In the C sum, they have given you a triangle. There is a triangle. 9, 11, 14 and here height is given as 7. So when we consider in this triangle 14 as a base and height as 7, so we write here base is 14 centimeter, height is 7 centimeter. So what is area of triangle? Therefore, area of triangle is half into base into height. That is half into 14 into 7. Now 2 will go in 14 7 times. 7 sevens are 49 centimeter square. So area of given triangle is 49 centimeter square. Next, D. What is the D diagram given for us? A rectangle. So in a rectangle, base is 14, length is 14, breadth is 7 centimeter. So what is area of rectangle formula? Area of rectangle is length into breadth, which is 14 into 7, which is 98 centimeter square. 7 fours are 28, carry 2, 7 ones are 7 plus 2, 98 centimeter square. Then the last shape. What is the last shape given? Square. There is a square. How we are saying it as square? Because adjacent sides are same, equal. So it is a square. So what is area of square? Area of square is side into side, which is 7 into 7, 49 centimeter square. So we can see that they have said to match us with 98 or 77 or 49. See, we got all the measurements in the three answers only. So we will match it like area of parallelogram is 98 centimeter square. Area of semicircle is 77 centimeter square. Then we have area of triangle 49 centimeter square. Then area of rectangle 98 centimeter square. Then area of a square 49 centimeter square. So we have done the first subdivision. But our question doesn't end there. In the B part, they have given us write the perimeter of each shape. Write the perimeter of each shape. So we do from the first again. So what is the first one we got? First one is area of parallelogram. So what is the perimeter of a parallelogram? Like that we will find and we will get the answer for each one. We know perimeter of parallelogram. I told you just what we should do. Add up all the four sides and we should get the answer. So now second subdivision talks about write the perimeter of each shape. For that the diagram is given rectangle and square. So we have to find the perimeter of rectangle and the perimeter of square. For the rectangle you have length and breadth as 14 and 7. So we find perimeter of rectangle is 2 into L plus B. 2 into length plus breadth. This is 2 into L. Length is given as 14 centimeter. Breadth is given as 7 centimeter, which is 2 into 21. What is 2 into 21? 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. 42 centimeter. So perimeter of rectangle is 42 centimeter. Then the second diagram is given as square, which is perimeter of square. What is perimeter of square formula? 4 into side. Here side is given as 7 centimeter. So 4 sevens are 28 centimeter. So now we have completed the first try this of this chapter from page 170. Hope you would have understood this one, how to find. Now we continue with that in the next page, exercise 11.1. In the exercise 11.1, in the first sum, a square and rectangular field with measurement as given in the figure have same perimeter. Which field has larger area? That is, they have given one square of 60 and another one of rectangle only with the length 80. But they have given one condition, they have same perimeter, which have same perimeter. That means perimeter of square is equal to perimeter of rectangle. So we do the sum like, in exercise 11.1, first one, first they have given a square. Square of measurement 60 meter. Then they have given us one rectangle also with the length 80 meter. And they have given one condition, perimeter of square is equal to perimeter of rectangle. They have same perimeter. It's given perimeter of square is equal to perimeter of rectangle. Now what is perimeter of square? 4 into side is equal to perimeter of rectangle is 2 into L plus B. We substitute the values. 4 into 60 is equal to 2 into 80 plus B. 2 into length is given as 80. Breadth they have not given. We have to find. Now 4 into 60. 4, 6 are 24. 2, 40. This 2 will become division 2 is equal to 80 plus B. This multiplication 2 get transposed to other side as division 2. So 2 will go into 40, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 0, 120. Plus 80 get transposed here, minus 80. So what is 120 minus 80? Breadth is 40 centimeter. So now we got it by using perimeter of square is equal to perimeter of rectangle. This is given in the question. They have same perimeter. So we say perimeter of square is equal to perimeter of rectangle. What is perimeter of square formula? 4 into side is equal to 2 into L plus B. We substitute the values. 4 into 60, because side of the square is given as 60, is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. Length of the rectangle is given as 80 plus B. Now we simplify this. 460s are 240. Multiplication 2 here comes transpose to other side as division 2. So 2 will go in 240 120 times. And this 80 get transposed as minus 80. So 120 minus 80, breadth is 40. Now what we have to find, which has larger area? So now we find area of square. What is area of square formula? Side into side. That is 60 into 60, 3600 centimeter square. Next we find area of rectangle. What is area of rectangle formula? Length into breadth. What is length for us? 80. Breadth is 40. What is 80 into 40? 0. 4 zeros are 0. 4 8s are 32. 3200 centimeters squared. Now you compare. Area of a square is 3600. Area of rectangle is 3200. Now they have asked you which is bigger. We write now. Therefore, area of square, that is 3600 centimeters squared, is greater than area of rectangle, that is 3200 centimeter square. So now therefore square has larger area. Okay, so now you have understood by the question square and perimeter of square and perimeter of rectangle have same measurement. So we use the formula 4 into side is 2 into L plus B. In that, side of square we know, length of rectangle we know. We substitute and simplify and get the value of breadth. Then to find the area of square and rectangle. Why? Because they asked you which has larger area. To compare and find which is larger area, we should find area of a square side into side, 3600 centimeter square. Then area of rectangle, length into breadth, which is 80 into 40, 3200 centimeter square. So when we compare, we find area of a square 3600 centimeter square is greater than area of rectangle 3200 centimeter square. Therefore, square has larger area. So now we have completed the first. So in today's class, we learned so many formulas. That last year's what we learned, perimeter of square, rectangle and areas, all those formulas. So your homework is read all the formula and write once and be very thorough with the formulas. So in the next video when we start doing the sums, because straight away when the sums we finish, we'll start use the formula and we will be doing it. So while using the formula, you should have all the formulas on your fingertips. So keep reading. Keep all the formulas in your memory. In the next video, we will start from question number 2. And we'll continue our 11.1 exercise. Till then, keep learning and get clarified if you have any doubts through WhatsApp. See you in the next class.